Now I have converted our previous program into a class called Star. The class Star has to have the same name that we've saved it as. We have our initial variables, and I've set everything to zero because we're going to pass in real variables. These are just placeholders. Our constructor will call from another program, and it has to have the same name as the program, and it declares what variables we're going to bring in. Temp x, temp y, temp square. Then we're going to set our initial variables, square, x, and y, to the ones that were passed in. X equals temp x, y equals temp y, square equals temp square. Then we have our display method, which puts our star on the screen. So now we need to create a program, and we'll go ahead and do a file save as. And we'll just call it display star. And now we need to create our program and create an instance of our class. So we're going to create star my star, and then we're going to have our void setup, and we need to declare our size. And we need to create an instance of our star. My star equals a new instance of star, and we have to pass it in whatever the constructor asks for, and it asks for an x coordinate, a y coordinate, and square, which is our representing our square from our graph paper. What do we want that to be worth? And we're going to say 5 pixels. And then we're going to have void draw. And in this, we're just going to call my star dot display, because that's what we called our function here. And if I didn't make any errors in either one, because I'm doing this live, sort of, it will work. And there we go. Now I could add more of them. But it's going to be in exactly the same place here. I could display it again. There's two on top of each other. You can't tell. But I could have more. And so here I could have my star equals new star, and so we'll make this my star 2, and we'll make this 400, 400, and 10. And we could keep going with that. So that's just taking something we've done in the past, converting it to a class, and then calling it. We're using that as an object, so we could call it as many times as we wanted, and we could make it move. I will do that in the next video. I'm going to show you how to add the ability to make it move.